Eric Bakker, thanks for coming back. We're going to talk about ganoderma, lucidum, or reishi mushroom. Mushroom extract is very popular with people, especially people who suffer from conditions like hepatitis or HIV/AIDS, autoimmune people. People with many chronic diseases often rely on different mushroom extracts. There are many different types of mushrooms you can get. You know, you can get caterpillar fungus and you can get turkey tail, and they've got funny names, but they contain special sugars or polysaccharides in them that have an interesting effect on the immune function. So they help basically the immune system recognize, you know, pathogens or bad cells by showing the immune system receptor sites on these cells, literally putting a spotlight on them so the immune system can target and kill them more effectively. They also improve various aspects of your immune system by reducing inflammation and stimulating also the killer cells to allow them to attack and kill cells that are unwanted or rogue cells in the body. They used a lot also for cancer for that reason, to keep the immune system quite clean and pure. And a nice effect on the liver. There are a couple of different liver enzymes that are normalized by these polysaccharides or these special sugars. But because it's a mushroom, people freak out and think, well, I've got candida, which is fungal, you know, and I shouldn't really be taking mushrooms in, but nothing could be further from the truth. These things are perfectly fine to have. In fact, I've got no problem with people eating, you know, mushrooms in their diet, as long as they cook them properly and don't have them raw. There's no problem in having those with your candida at all. Not shouldn't be an issue. So is this particular fungus good for candida? Yes, it is. It can have some spectacular effects for some people. But for other people I know who take mushroom extracts for years, they fail to make any change in their stool test whatsoever with candida, especially the more invasive ones or the more difficult to treat, like candida glabrata, candida auris, and candida parallopsilosis. They tend to be a little bit more elusive. But candida albicans, or the common one, definitely gets nailed more easily by extracts like the ganoderma. So am I in favor of mushroom extracts for candida? I am. But don't use them as a primary way of cleansing candida from the body. They're far more effective supplements to take when it comes to candida, particularly if you're going to use combinations of grapefruit seed extract with garlic extract, and then some monounsaturated, some fatty acids along with that, like, you know, the caprylic acid and the undecanoic acid. If you put them together, you get a way, way better team that's more effective at targeting a wide range of not just candida in the gut, but also bacteria that are unwanted and parasites. So I prefer to use more of a broad spectrum antimicrobial than just this pure specific thing like reishi or ganoderma. So yeah, there you have it. But if you've got an autoimmune disease, it's certainly worth trying mushroom extracts like this to see if they affect the autonuclear antibody or the inflammatory pathways. If they start, you know, normalizing with reishi, definitely stay on it. But if they start elevating, then get off it, because it can go either way with autoimmune. For cancer, excellent. This is quite a good supplement to take for people also with HIV. And many HIV people will take a mushroom extract just like this for that reason, because it helps to normalize the immune function. Thanks for the question.